Hi guys, and welcome back to our channel. What's Web3 and what's DeFi, decentralized finance? These terms are taking the world by storm right now, and everyone is excited and everyone is interested to know more and more about them. But in this video, we'll be talking in depth what to expect and how to understand how to get your way around these new emerging technologies. We'll be talking about that in the next few minutes, but as usual, this only for educational purposes, it's not financial advice, and let's dive deep into it. So guys, we start now with the definition of Web3. What's Web3? Web3, simply speaking, here is the decentralized internet built on an open blockchain network that's not owned or controlled by large entities, meaning that it's a decentralized internet. What does decentralized means? Meaning that it's away from control of major companies, entities, or whatever. Nobody is controlling it apart from people using it, meaning that it's not controlled by an individual, it's not controlled by an entity, so it's more flexible and it gives more freedom and it cannot be hacked. Blockchain technology cannot be hacked. So as you can see here, Web3 is a third generation of the internet currently being built, where websites and apps will be able to process information in a smart human-like way through technology like artificial intelligence, AI, machine learning, big data, decentralized ledger technology, and more. Currently, as we speak, Web3 is a rather undefined concept that could take 5 to 10 years to build. And if we look at the transition from Web 2 to Web 3, actually, we might very well first see a prolongated era of Web 2.5, meaning that it's kind of in between 2 and 3, but Web 3 is currently taking off and is currently accelerated more than people expected, but Web 3 protocols are quite useful. Furthermore, here, users and machines will be able to interact with data, and this will enable programs and users to interact in a very efficient way and in a very open and flowing way. So here I would say that Web3 is kind of semantic web and artificial intelligence technology, and this will give the probability for even further and more development for many, many projects to come. So what's Web3 used for? Well, you might have heard about the usage of Web3 or the projects built on Web3. First of all, Metaverse. How many times have you heard the word Metaverse in the recent year or so? You know that Facebook even changed its name to Meta, or the company called Meta right now, referring to the Metaverse. It's kind of a universe built on the Web3. Let's put it this way. So Metaverse is one major project now. It's led by many companies. Facebook has its own approach. Google has its own approach. Major tech companies have their own approach. VR sets and artificial intelligence is playing a major role in the Metaverse, meaning that everyone is trying to create a bubble or a universe built upon their idea. So the Metaverse is built on Web3, and it's a decentralized project. It's a decentralized ambition here to build on Web3. So as you can see, it will be 3D and it will be interconnecting everything. Again, Web 2.5 will likely come in with both industry taking ideas from one another and working together in order to make the Metaverse a reality. As you can see, it's slowly developing, slowly but steadily picking up here. But the Metaverse is a major project and it's a major topic right now for everyone to talk about. Blockchain gaming, that's an interesting topic built on Web3 as well. If you're a gamer, if you like games, if you want to play online, then blockchain gaming is also a new concept built on Web3. You know about Axie Infinity. You might have heard about Axie Infinity. It has taken off in 2021, kicked off the play to earn P2E. As you can see here, many Web2 gaming and great games actually, they're trying to merge now into the Web3 and to utilize the powers and the amazing features of Web3. So things are looking that Web3 is taking over even in the gaming community. And here also you will have another usage for Web3, which is creator economy. These are benefiting from creators, and creators are also benefiting from these institutions. But here the Web3, this will kind of change the game a little bit. Web3 meaning that you're the owner and also you're the benefiter of that. And also people who are listening to you, people who are interacting with you, they can also benefit. So it's kind of opening a new door for everyone to benefit from using the internet itself. So it's a new approach, it's a new very ambitious approach, and things are looking very promising also for creators and for consumers to have the Web3 building upon for everything and being a layer and being a foundation for their projects. So here we have decentralized autonomous organizations. What's decentralized autonomous organizations? It's referred to as DAOs. You also might have heard about DAOs before. DAOs here, it's kind of a powerful decentralized automation for organizations, and DAOs is creating a democratized and self-governing organization that will transcend human interface and geographical challenges through the power of smart contracts. You know, Ethereum is building smart contracts nowadays, or most of the smart contracts are built on Ethereum. What's a smart contract? Smart contract means that it doesn't need a human interface. It doesn't need a human intervening any of the process. You will give it some conditions. If the conditions are fulfilled, then a contract is going on or a certain action is going on. So DAOs have taken some flake also due to the crypto projects trying to governance the token and soon become worthless. But DAO currently still remain, and the innovation in DAO still remains very dominant in the market, and it also has a great future. Decentralized finance, DeFi, that's also another term which is roaming around nowadays, and many people are using DeFi. DeFi meaning that these are exchanges, let's put it in a simple way. These are exchanges away from any entities for control or whatever. You as a consumer A, you want to interact with a consumer B, you want to exchange some value, crypto, NFTs, whatever, then you can exchange it based on also Web3. So Web3 and the cryptocurrencies of course are somehow used in the Web3, or actually heavily used in Web3, and these are also used for the Web3 technologies, and this all together creates the solid foundation and the solid case of use for Web3 for everyone to be more and more interested and more excited about the development of Web3, and even get more involved. If you have a project, if you're developing a project, you might need to consider developing it on Web3 and start using all the amazing features that happens when you start embedding Web3 technology in your development.
So guys, in a nutshell, we talked about Web3, we talked about DeFi, we talked about DAOs. We gave all the information needed for you to start understanding what's going on and start in the process of getting involved into this new emerging technology. So my advice for you, check the links down below, get yourself more informed, get yourself more involved. And as usual, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, leave any comment you might have in the comment section down below. And until next one, bye-bye.